to be with you. The church leaders are going to support you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So the church in Vihiga is supporting this ministry.
Glory to God.
We need now to be here to say, yes, the commandant, we are here to support you. Call us anytime, we'll be able to come. If one of the police officers has gone haywire, call us. We'll be able to talk to them, to speak to them, to pray with them. And the prayer is powerful.
Amen.
Let us not leave prayer behind. Let us put the prayer ahead of us. I'm almost finished. Now, how can we build the house of God without having a lot of blemishes? One, if we can avoid sin in the leadership, if the leadership can avoid sinning, if we avoid sin in the leadership, God will bless us.
Amen.
That's point number one. Sin in leadership should be avoided. And if it happens, if something happens, the Bible is so clear. It says, my pastors, my righteous ones, my righteous people can fall 7 times and I still raise them.
Amen.
So even the church leader has fallen once, God is capable of raising him a second time.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Don't use the past to ridicule a leader, because God gives seven opportunities that he will raise a leader who has fallen 7 times. That's the advantage. When you are with the Lord, when you backslide, when a sin comes into your life, you go back and remember God. But when somebody does not know the Lord, when he falls, he forgets. And that's why God will be able to stand with the leaders in Vihiga. And they will do what God has commanded them to do. And we will walk, and we shall reach where we are going. Because God is with us. Hallelujah!
Hallelujah.
Second point that I have in mind. Ignorance and not knowing what to do. My friends, we should not be ignorant. We should not be ignorant. We should not know what we want to do. We should be aware so that we are not ignorant. We must know what to do and we must not be ignorant. God has not given us this chapel because we are the best and because we are sinless. No! God has given us this place and he wants to see whether we are going to be ignorant or not. If we are going to be ignorant, the Bible very clearly says, even if you see this church, even if you see this temple, as glorious as it is, if you do not follow my steps, what I told you at times when I was in Egypt, I will leave this place. It was useless. So our brothers who are the police force, the chaplain, let the church leaders and pastors be close. Because there is a moment, people will say, okay, this useless leader has no time to go to your course. Let us set them aside. You will be very ignorant. Remember those of you who were with you when you were in trouble. When this chapel will be okay, maybe some of us will come here when we are old enough. You start saying, who you say, man, be a cry, okay? My friends, be watchful. Big people who are here, whether they are weak, poor, remember them as we walk. Because I don't know what the Lord has for this chapel. Maybe put them work hard. Only people who are driving Mercedes-Benz are the ones allowed. My friends, allow them those who be walking. Don't let the story of those people who are invited, they never came. Until now, the owner of the banquet went around saying, everybody on the street, come. No, we want this place, God to bless them. Even if we have more than one service, let it be.
Hallelujah.
Number three, idolatry and curses. Today, we are cursing and we are refusing all the curses and the adultery in this chapel. In the name of Jesus, all those things should be thrown away. Don't